Hurry on to one and all present here. Happy Ganesh Chaturthi to everyone. So I'm here to give a speech on the topic, who is Ganesh to me? Is he a friend, a prankster, a very playful child, or a very intelligent child? So I would start by asking, what is a friend? A friend is a person who obviously has the characteristics of a friend, but also a person who corrects you. Not just a person who entertains you by making you laugh, but a person who corrects your mistakes and your wrongdoings. That's who I consider Ganesha as a friend. I take him as the embodiment of knowledge. He teaches everyone, while he indirectly teaches everyone about the sources of life and our entire purpose, which people wouldn't ordinarily find by searching on ChatGPT, artificial intelligence, or even Google. Only God can explain some things which are inexplainable. So Ganesha is also a prankster sometimes. I can definitely not say no to that. So I'm going to share one time that Ganesha was a prankster, but instantly made up for it. So Ganesha was loved to walk around the Kailasha Parbat, and he was near a cave when he saw a cat. In his normal prankster fashion, he decided to grab the cat by the tail and start twisting it. He kept doing that until the cat yowled in pain. When I read this story, I couldn't bear to think that Ganesha would do such a thing, but he really is a prankster. And a really playful child too. So once it yowled in pain, it went back to the place where it lived, to its mother cat. So after Ganesha walked around for a little while, he went back to his house. On the walk back, he felt really hungry. So when he went back, he asked Mother Parvati for some fruits. And he was surprised to see Mother Parvati come out covered in dust and bruises. He hugged his mother and asked her why she was injured and who injured her. Only then it struck Ganesha. Him twisting the tail of the cat was what made her get bruised. She was the mother of all living beings on earth, so obviously she had to share her life with all living beings. And a part of her life residing within the cat injured her. So Ganesha felt really, really mournful and sad and cried over this. Mother Parvati assured him it is no problem and just not to repeat his mistakes and to learn from them. So another lesson we learn from this is that when we hurt a living being, whether anyone sees it or not, God is always watching. And you're indirectly hurting God as He resides in every living being. So we should also never hurt other animals. So I see Ganesha as a friend to me, and I want him to be my remover of obstacles as he already is. He helps people grasp success from the jaws of failure. So I would like to end my speech by saying Ganapati Bappa Moriya. Hari Om.